So, Chuck, my wife was recently in a car accident. She went to the hospital, and the hospital administrators, the people that have you fill out all the forms, they were insisting that she give the other driver's insurance information instead of just her own health insurance. So, what's the deal with that?
Well, one, they're trying to make more money. And the reason I'm saying that is they're assuming, they're making a lot of assumptions. One, the accident was the other person's fault. Two, the other person had insurance. Three, that the other person had enough insurance to cover their bill. Instead of billing your health insurance, and presumably they have a contract, let's assume that it's one of the hospitals here and they have a contract with UnitedHealthcare. And they know that they're going to get more money for the services rendered if they reach into your settlement proceeds, which by law they can do. But that's the way they play this game. But the assumptions are crazy because you could be wheeled in there on a stretcher. It could have been totally your fault, and they're asking for this information instead of billing, UnitedHealthcare or Blue Cross Blue Shield or something. And that's how they try to make more money on these deals. So you insist, one, that they take your health insurance information, two, that they bill your health insurance information, and quite frankly, I'm not really sure it's their business or you even have the information relative to the, we'll call them the bad guys, car insurance to be able to give that to them. But this has become somewhat of a major pain in the rear for me because I see clients that have great health insurance and they've never been billed. And I'm wondering why. And they go in and the hospital had taken down, somehow gotten all the information from the bad guy driver, maybe through the police officer that showed up with you as you were wheeled into the hospital. But then they start billing them and they don't have to pay until a court, say a jury after a trial, says we got a judgment against this bad person that caused the accident. That insurance carrier doesn't have to pay out a penny. So they're not going to pay your hospital bills. And if they don't, they're eventually going to go into collection and you're going to wonder, why wasn't my health insurance paying this? And you're going to find out they were never billed. And I have seen so much of this in the last year, and it's wrong. You insist, assuming you're capable of insisting, physically, that they bill your health insurance company. And I don't see where there's any obligation where you have to give them the bad guy's car insurance information, or your own for that matter. It's just the health insurance. And you sign off on a financial responsibility form that says your health insurance is going to pay for it, or you're going to pay for your co-pays, deductibles, things like that. But if you give them all the information from the bad guy's automobile insurance, they try billing them, even though I've explained to the billing people, the financial people, that's not where you need to go. But they're thinking they're going to make more money by reaching in to your settlement proceeds, taking money out of what amounts to your pocket and billing them more than they would have collected from your health insurance carrier. Does that make sense?
Does. Thank you.
You're welcome.
This posted video is in no way specific legal advice on any subject. It is intended to provide general information for the public. If you need specific legal advice, call Chuck at 480-545-0700.